This is Silenced by a Spell, a Lacey Doyle cozy mystery, book 7, written by Fiona Grace, narrated by Mary Sarah. Chapter 1. Lacey rubbed her fatigued eyes and glanced down at her extensive to-do list. Who knew a supposedly low-key wedding took so much planning? So far, she decided on the theme. Rustic romance, and a color palette of ivory and taupe. She'd picked the flowers, orchids, white roses, and dried hydrangeas, which Gina was now taking full ownership over. But whether she wanted gilded tableware or burlap linens, or stain-finished banquet tables still eluded her. "I swear my to-do list is breeding," she murmured to herself, tucking a dark curl behind her ear. Of course, this wasn't her first time down the aisle. Indeed, it wasn't Tom's either. Because of their past histories, they'd both been very certain about not wanting an elaborate blowout this time around. And yet somehow there was still so much to decide. Decisions that would be infinitely more easy to make if Lacey addressed the elephant in the room. The unspoken question mark of her father. She glanced over the envelope she'd received from him, his RSVP to her wedding invite. Weeks had passed since it had arrived. She'd not yet built up the courage to open it, just as she had with every step along the way in her search for her missing father. Lacey's fear was her biggest roadblock. Losing the truth of his abandonment after all these years caused her more anxiety than her fantastical ruminations did. At least in her mind he could be a spy, rather than just a man who turned his back on his parental duties. Ever since the letter arrived, Lacey had been telling herself she'd open it tomorrow. But she kept pushing tomorrow back and back. She couldn't stand the thought of him declining the invite and not being there to walk her down the aisle. Missing a pivotal moment in her life, just as he had her marriage to David. So the envelope had remained unopened, waiting, just so Lacey could cling onto that small sliver of hope that it said he was coming. Just then, Lacey heard a gentle knock on the door. She swiveled in her office chair. "Come in." The door opened a few inches. A takeaway coffee cup emerged through the gap. "Pumpkin spice latte," came Gina's disembodied voice. Lacey smiled at her friend's generosity. "Thank you." But in the next instant, she became suspicious. Gina only ever bought her things to butter her up. "What have you done?" Lacey asked, directing a question to the coffee cup holding hand of Gina. The door was pushed fully open to reveal the older woman. She was dressed in a long brown cotton dress and white apron, a lace-up bodice, and a white frilly bonnet perched on her grey hair. Pointy suede shoes poked out from beneath the folds of her skirt. She was in costume. Lacey groaned. Halloween was fast approaching, and she'd never been particularly fond of the holiday. The town of Wilfordshire, England, where she lived, on the other hand, seemed absolutely obsessed with it. Gina in particular seemed to think it was the best thing since sliced bread. She hadn't stopped asking Lacey when she'd be allowed to dress up for work for weeks now. Lacey had felt like she'd been in a tug of war with a child rather than a 60-odd-year-old woman. "Gina, we've talked about this," Lacey told her best friend and employee.
I know,
Gina interjected before Lacey had a chance to say any more.
"No costumes until Halloween, but the decorations are going up in the high street, and everyone else in town is wearing one."
She paced inside the office and thrust the coffee cup under Lacey's nose, squinching her eyes to see if her apology latte would work. Lacey narrowed her eyes. With defeat, she took the takeout coffee cup from Gina. The gorgeous smell of ginger wafted into her nostrils.
So, what are you supposed to be? She asked, scanning Gina's costume from head to toe. Some kind of peasant woman?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.